Yes, I welcome you once again. Today I want to talk to you, my beloved people. I want to talk to you concerning what God said in His Word concerning all that is going on. I don't really blame you so much, but I have to blame you. Because some things that we normally do at times, we think it is right or it is okay in our eyes. But I want you to understand that what controls the whole world is the Word of God. Anything that the Word of God said is final. And you have to always watch your life, check your life, anything you are doing. Go to the Word of God like a mirror. You know, every morning when you wake up, you check yourself in the mirror. Always go to the Word of God and know what the Word of God said about what you are doing or what you want to do. I think it's important for me to open your eyes for some important issue concerning making quick money. Quick money. Yahoo, Yahoo, as we all know. Yahoo, Yahoo. Yahoo, Yahoo. No. I believe in truth. I want to tell you that Jesus did not hate you. Jesus did not condemn you. But your character and your conduct is the only thing that can condemn you if you refuse to hands up. You will condemn yourself, not Jesus condemning you. If you hear the word of God and you remove your hands from what you are doing that is not right, then you are not condemned. Jesus will have mercy. But if you hear the word and you say, who is he that is speaking? I don't want to hear, or who is this man? Then you throw the word away. Then you are condemning yourself. You condemn yourself. Nobody condemns you. Nobody condemns you. Jesus does not condemn you. You condemn yourself by refusing to accept the word of God. So I want to talk to you today about flood, internet flooding, and the government in every area are making quick money, trying to make money in a quick way, in a shortcut. It's dangerous. So I want to show you what God said, to read something God said about it so that you can understand by yourself. I'm talking about Yahoo or flooding or all of them, I don't know the name. So I want to read something for you in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 17. Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 11. As a partridge that grows but does not hatch, so is he who gets riches but not by right. It will leave him in the midst of his days, and at his end he will be a fool. Listen once again, Jeremiah 17, verse 11. As a partridge that brews but does not hatch, so is he who gets riches but not by right. It will leave him in the midst of his days, and at his end he will be a fool. You know, this is a kind of bed, that go and brood, upon a egg, like let me say, like as a partridge, there's a kind of bed, a partridge that brews blood but does not hatch. So you see, who gets riches but not by right, something that you don't work out by yourself, something that you don't not labor, not labor to get, something that somebody labored, and like a fowl that lay egg and take time, the fowl lay egg, carry the egg for some months, lay the egg, incubate the egg until the baby formed and totally properly formed before the time for the baby to come out. It's a process. So a process of somebody laboring, you carry the vision, you carry the vision in your heart, you work with the good things out of you. You labored to bring the good destiny, good thing out of you. You suffered. So this is what God is trying to say. So if you did not labor to to make money by yourself, and you want to go and take what someone else labored for. You want to go and take it through lying, through deceit, through evil means. You want to take it away from that person. You know, this is how it is. You know, Bible says that if you try to follow that means, that way to get it, it is dangerous. It is dangerous. You know, that thing is about to leave you. That wealth is about to leave you. Those money is about to leave you in the midst of the day. And at the end of the day, you become a big fool. Everybody will look at you and call you a fool. You know, so that was I, the Lord, say, as a partridge that broods but does not hatch. As a partridge that broods but does not hatch. So is he who gets riches, but not by right means, a right way, a right process, the right procedure, So is he who gets riches but not by right. It will leave him in the midst of his days. That wealth will leave you in the midst of the day. And at his end, he will be a fool. This is what is happening. You will gather the money, something blew it away, because that thing is not having a root. It's not having a root. It's like a wind. You fly away. You gather millions, thousands of dollars on oil for your fraud people, and that thing take it away. Can't you see that you are deceiving yourself? You can't even account every time you are trying to catch the air, you can catch air. You will get, you think you get it, but you don't get it. You will fly away. It will go away. It doesn't have root. Okay, so we move on now. I want to take you to Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 10. Let's go to the book of Proverbs to see what is there too. I'm only advising you to remove your hands from what you are doing and do the right thing. That God will have mercy upon you. Anything that you lay your hand, God will bless it, than taking what somebody else have labored, you know, for labor for years and acquire. You use a lying means and evil means and take it away from that person. What kind of a joy are you going to have? What kind of peace are you going to have when you cause somebody, when you cause your fellow human being pain? So remember, whatever thing a man sow, that will reap. So we move on now. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 11. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 11. Wealth gained by dishonesty. Through lying. Dishonesty means not truthful, not truthful, not in a truthful way, not in a right way. Wealth gained through lying. Lying means, no. Wealth gained by dishonesty will be diminished. But he who gathers by labor will increase. There is nothing like what you use your hand. You labored, you cultivate, you labored, you work it out, you work by yourself. There is nothing like that. That thing will remain in your hand. Nothing will take it away from you because you labored. You sweat to get it. It is yours. It belongs to you. No man, no one will take it away from you. If you eat it, it will give you joy. It will be sweet to your soul. You gather millions. You go to hotel. Tell me, you buy an expensive car. You go to hotel with ladies. You drink. You buy a bottle of wine or champagne or whatever. 20,000 naira or euro or anything. You stage party. You wear most expensive rich watches and shoes and everything. Before it was happening, the money is gone. Because you don't get it in the right way. You don't get it. It has no root. That money is not having root. And every time you are still in lack. You are still lacking. No peace. Don't have peace. So what kind of life are you living? What kind of life is that? So I want you to think about what I'm saying. Before I now end this video, I want to read once more a particular place for you to hear, in the same place of Romans chapter, Proverbs chapter 10, 2, 10 verse 2. Proverbs 10 verse 2. Treasures of wickedness profit nothing. Treasures of wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivers from death. Treasures you are gathering through wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivers from death. Okay, I read 21 verse 6 for you. 21 verse 6. Getting treasures by a lying tongue is the fleeting fantasy of those who seek death. All right, so I just want to give you this way to think about it and see you very soon. I will keep updating you, telling you everything God is saying. Remember to subscribe and always get in touch. Write, ask questions. I'm there for you, as you're always there for me. God bless you all. See you. Bye.